Anybody can serve God when it's all going good. But they had their paddles out. Simon Peter was no stranger to this. John was no stranger. You know what they probably thought when that storm first came up? I got this. I've been through storm before. But they ain't never been one like that. And all of a sudden they got afraid. How many of y'all ever done something a lot and then the same thing you done a lot, you got scared? Bill Lamont, you here? He's my buddy. Bill's the reason I'm saved. Bill's kind of crazy. James, is he crazy? James said about like that, Bill. He ain't saying you're all crazy. But I remember a night you was kind of crazy when you was with me. We went fishing at Middle Allen Creek. That's, by the way, for you that don't know that, Middle Allen Creek is in St. Mary's. It's the longest creek in West Virginia. It's almost a river. It's 99.8 miles long. We were on that creek. The biggest, worst storm in the world came up. We had one more guy with us. I told him to take a truck down there. Me and Bill, we had trot lines. Anybody know what a trot line is? Yo, what's wrong with y'all? A bunch of city slickers? That's where you put, you can't do that now. You put a line on one end and then the other end, and you put anchors on them, put bait on it, and catch them big old catfish about like that. Now you can't do that. You only put a line on one end, you got to put an anchor, you can't put it on both ends. I'm just giving y'all the law. Storm came up. I said, Bill, come on, let's go real quick, go get that trot line. Oh, you know Bill, he'll follow his preacher. He got in that boat. Bill, did you think you was going to die? Dave, we ain't had no light. We had a little old tie flashlight, and it was blinking. We going down through it, lightning was striking on my head. I'm telling you, we was in an aluminum boat, paddling. Bill went back and said, I'm going to die. And then in my spirit, I said, I'm going to die. And then we got in that boat, and we got that trot line. I said, oh, God, we're going to die. And somehow, we got over there, got in that truck, and I went, phew. Hey, some of you, huh? Hey, some of you right in the middle right now, and you're saying, I am not going to get through this. But here's what happened. Oh, I like this. There's about 20 or 30 furlongs along. Then guess what happened? Somebody come walking on the water. How many of y'all believe that? Somebody, and by the way, number one, you ought to, when you're in a trial, you keep on rowing. Number two, when Jesus passes by, you better willingly bring him in. Hey, Bill, when we saw that old boy in that truck, and he's out there to help us get that, how many of you, we were willing to have him help us. I want you to know something. There's some of you, maybe you're lost, maybe you're boxing, maybe your life's a mess today. You know why you're still in the middle of your storm. You're not willing to let the Lord come in and take care of you. Hey, I want to tell you what, when I'm in a storm, be willing. Amen. That's the triumph. What do you do? Keep rowing. You say, I got blisters. Man, I'm going to tell you what. If this wasn't the wildest week of pastoring I've ever been in, I ain't never been in one. Wednesday, I had a multitude of people in my office all day. I don't even know who was there all day. But they were there all day long. All day long. I had to take preachers out. It was all day long. It's been a week, man. I was in there Friday, and the phone rang 714 times, and I even answered. People said, well, you don't answer the phone. I said, secretary's off this afternoon. My wife's off today. They off on Friday. The preachers are both off, but I'm here. I'm answering the phone. Hello? You got to keep rowing. You got to keep rowing. There ain't nowhere to stop. You deacons ain't nowhere to stop. God bless this place. Now, Sunday, we're going to have our board meeting. You got to keep rowing. Hey, you got to keep on rowing. And but by the way, but when it gets real tough and you get afraid, there's going to be somebody come walking on the water, and you better willingly let him in. Here, if you're lost this morning, you need to willingly let him in. Now, I've got to give you the last point. I don't want to, Aubrey, this is about the best point I ever made, and I'm about ready to shout. The transporting of their faith. Read that, Nate. Look at that verse. Give it to me. Where's that? You have the right Bible?
I do.
Okay. Okay. You sure? It don't look like no King James Bible to me. It is? Okay. Y'all with me? Look at verse 21. Then they willingly received him into the ship. Now they're halfway in, Jared. And immediately, the ship was at land. They 2.5 or 3 miles in. They got 3 miles to go. That's the transportation of your faith. Now you say, I don't believe that. You know what I believe? I believe supernaturally. The one that walked on the water lifted the boat up to the other side, and them boys were still rowing and beating up mud while they're on the other side. Somebody help me preach. I know some of you's going through valleys. I know you're going through a dark storm. I know it's darker than it's ever been, dangerous than it's ever been. I know you're down right now. Oh, listen, don't quit rowing. Just welcome him in. But let me give you some promises. He will transport you and take you to the other side, because he told him to go to the other side.